More than 7 billion people on this planet, all of us unique, all of us with a different personality. The question I wanted to ask you today is, how seriously do you take yourself and how easy is it for you to laugh at yourself? Hello, Assalamu Alaikum. Welcome to Talk About with Shabnam Riaz. I bet that question has got you thinking, hasn't it? Well, if I talk about myself, I would like to say that I don't take myself so seriously, that I find it easy to laugh at myself. Well, I do find it easy to laugh at myself and the crazy things I do, embarrassing moments or awkward conversations or situations you've been in life. But taking myself too seriously, that may be a problem. There are times when I've thought to myself, you know, oh, I've got to loosen up. I shouldn't be taking myself so seriously. I should relax a bit. And that is the message that I want to take forward. Now, when I say that, it's not a question of coming across as a serious person. No, we're talking about the conversation that we're having with ourselves. You can be an extrovert, you can be a person who's the life of the party. At the same time, you could be sticking to things that people have said, taking them home with you and thinking about them and thinking, oh God, you know, I'm not happy about that. And you're second guessing yourself, you're spoiling your confidence. And those are the things that when I say you should loosen up a bit and not take yourself so seriously, that's what we're talking about. Another thing I've found is there are many people in our part of the world who, when you ask them a question, will actually say, hang on, I don't know the answer to that. In fact, in all the time that I have spent here in Pakistan, I don't think I have ever come across a person who has ever given me that answer. A little example, going out, getting lost somewhere and asking for directions. You may ask, you know, how can I get to this particular place? And people will give you all sorts of, you know, these sort of navigation. And then you have to turn right and you'll come to a roundabout and this will happen, that will happen. And then you realize after about 5 minutes, 10 minutes of getting even more lost, they didn't have the foggiest of what they were going on about. So then you think, you know, wouldn't it have been better for you to say, I'm sorry, I don't know where that is. Why can't we say that? Why is it so hard to say those three words? I don't know. Again, this is not a reflection on you as a personality. This is not a reflection on your knowledge, your skill, your expertise. No, it's not humanly possible for a person to know everything. So of course, there are going to be instances when you don't know the answer to something. So I think that actually makes you more human and it makes you more real. And in a fake world, being real is just, that is amazing. Having integrity, being able to say, being able to embrace those things that you may see as imperfections, but actually they're not. It's a human quality to be imperfect. None of us can be perfect. We're not robots. We're not designed that way. So next time you think you don't know the answer to something, just try saying, I don't know. You actually may feel liberated. Okay, so many times when we are taking ourselves too seriously, we can tend to sort of harbor insecurities and let those insecurities, again, that's a natural thing for people to feel insecure in certain situations, but it's when we let our insecurities get the better of us, or we let them sort of mushroom to a level that it starts affecting our life, that is when we need to check things. So talk about your insecurities if you can with a family member, with a close friend. If you can't, just sit down and write them down. Write them down so that you can get clear in your head what it is you're insecure about. Okay, if you are a shy person, You may feel insecure when you're around somebody who has an outgoing personality. Again, that's very natural. What you have to do is you have to work on your insecurities. Otherwise, you will find that your insecurities are actually ruling you, and they are making you go into seclusion, isolation, cutting yourself off from situations where you should be. Why? Because the things that we're thinking in our head, you know, I don't need to be there. Why should I be there? What will I do there? Who will I talk to? I'm going to just stand there like a loser or a loner, and I don't want to do that. These are all the things that you're having with your own self-perception and your negative self-talk. So that's not what other people are thinking. That's what you're thinking. That's what your brain and your mind is telling you. You have to work on your insecurities so that you can get along with other people, so that you can maximize your social life, your healthy interaction. That is very, very important. Your healthy interaction, you're around people, and you know, you're in places where you feel good, and you're not necessarily secluding yourself or cutting yourself off from places that you would rather be. As I said before, it's things a person has gone through in life themselves. They've learned the hard way. So why not share it with other people? Because life is a sharing platform. It's why we've come into this world, to share each other's joys, happiness, burdens, sorrows, sadness. Help each other. That's the thing that we should be doing. And if we can help each other via something so simple as a YouTube channel, why not do that? In fact, I would encourage other people who think they have something to share and that they have something that can benefit another person, and try that. You never know how the impact of one person saying something can change someone's life. We need to laugh at ourselves a bit. Now, why do I say laugh at ourselves? Because many things happen. You might have a conversation that left you a bit sort of, what on earth did I say there, or what I shouldn't have said this, I should have said this. It's okay. Just have crack a joke. Humor, the best thing that you can use in your life is humor. And humor is something that has to be used correctly. Many times I have seen humor being directed at the expense of another person, where everybody else laughs except that person the joke was intended towards. That's not humor, that's being mean. If you really want to target someone and have a laugh at yourself, have a laugh at the things you may have done. Don't laugh at other people, actually, laugh with them. My children, the funny thing is that my children, whenever they watch my videos, they'll always be saying, "Oh, Mum, it looks like you're, you know, giving yourself self-therapy. You're talking about all those things that are a problem for you and how to face them." And, you know, it's very true, actually. We have a bit of a laugh about it, but it is true. I think that those things that you can relate to, the things that you have been through yourself, how you've struggled, how you've been able to overcome them, that is actually what makes something easy to relate to, and then you can share that experience with others because it's coming straight from the heart. It's something that you have been through. Sometimes the biggest enemy you can find is yourself, and that is because of the unachievable targets that we have set ourselves. You know, we say, okay, I did this, but it could have been much better. Okay, I said this, or that this was my presentation, but, and the world is, everybody there is congratulating you. Everybody there is saying, well done, you did a fantastic job. But you don't believe it. You don't believe it because of your insecurities and because of your lack of confidence. So you see, everything comes together. Everything, all these things come together. Our confidence levels, how kind we are to ourselves, and the perceptions we have, how seriously we take ourselves. If you're the type of person that will keep taking offense at other things. It's only going to make your own life more difficult, isn't it? So these are the main things that I wanted to talk about today, and I hope they have been helpful. I hope that somebody has learned something. It's been wonderful. It's been an honor and a privilege to be able to talk to you all. Until next time, bye.